Okay, obviously for Movember, you have a beautiful jacket on this evening, Don, and don't be like giving it just lip service. Let's make a contribution for prostate cancer and be like James Reimer. Great shave percentage. We'll get to him in a minute. What else you got?
I don't know. Anyhow, this here, tomorrow at 2 o'clock, the Brampton Beasts are putting, see, they're giving all the money to Wounded Warriors, my buddies, and anybody does that is okay in my book. Now, you know, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to do the Sang of Reimer, eh? He's my buddy. He's our buddy. He put the thing on and everything like that. Let's just go back and what he did. He put them in the playoffs, and they choked, and Boston beat them, right? Mm-hmm. So what do they do? Not the screw regime. They go out, and they get a backup goalie that's out west, and he's number one because they made the thing, and they shove him in the back. And this regime, they go out and sign Bernier to another contract. And I said, the very first coach's corner, I said, Bernier's got to play his way off the number one, and Reimer's got to play his way on, which he had. And I guarantee you right here, right now, that look at the saves he's making right now. What, he's got four wins in a row or something like that. This guy here would not be playing if Bernier hadn't got hurt. The only way he's playing is because he's playing. And you know what? When Bernier comes back, they'll try to get him number one. That's the way it works. This kid is playing so good. You know why? He's got his confidence. He's playing and playing and playing and
but
playing.
But, Don, the fact is, the new regime is Mike Babcock. It's, you know, how are you going to argue with that?
Well, what?
The new group. I mean,
so what? The new group is the one that signed Bernier to the contract.
So Lou Lamoriello and Mark Hunter and
all. What, are you afraid of those guys?
Kind of.
Well, they're all, everybody's afraid of them. I tell the truth. Right. You think I'm worried about anybody? I'm not. Reimer would not be playing if Bernier was healthy. I guarantee you that right now. All right.
Adam Oates just over here.
All right, Adam Oates. You're going to see Cadre pulling Adam Oates and watch JVR do the Brett Hall. Watch this here. That's there. There goes Adam. Dropped the puck. Looking back. Looking at Cadre. He zings it up. Look at Weber. It is. Look and say, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. Anyhow, we're going to show these composite sticks. Look at this like a slingshot. Look at Weber. Don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. And that's the way Brett Hall used to put him in. And that's the way Adam Oates, boy, I'll tell you, he used to lead the league all the time and drop passes.
Don, you've always been a fan of, first of all, Martin Jones. You were saying in net for the San Jose Sharks is a key to the
BC
deal.
BC boy, yeah.
But your guy.
My guy, I just love Brody. Watch this here.
No, no, sorry, Joel Ward first.
Oh, Joel Ward, you're going to do him first?
Yes.
All right, Joel Ward. Watch Joel Ward. Nobody wanted this kid, and he got drafted by the OHL 240th, I think. Nobody wanted him. Nobody wanted him in the National Hockey League. He was a walk-on. Ladies and gentlemen, he leads now the San Jose Sharks in scoring. He also leads them in the most accurate shot, the whole NHL, and he's the best guy on 64%, believe it or not, in the NHL, and nobody wanted him. And you kids out there, when you get drafted 248th and you can't make it and you think you're going to quit, just think of Joel Ward. He didn't quit, and look what he's doing now.
Okay, TJ Brody.
Okay, TJ Brody, another favorite of mine. Watch this here. Last night, he led the team in shots. This is the overtime goal, little pass like that. By the way, hardly likes to play two defensemen like everybody else. There he is in the end. But last night, he blocked the most shots of anybody on both teams. He had the most shots, and he set up that goal. And that's why Hartley likes to play two defensemen, because he's got the defensemen to play it.
And a goalie that this is the thing you really like in the three-on-three. Kari Ramo first.
Hold on. Okay. Watch the goaltenders move this puck. Watch Ramo move this puck. Never on a three-on-three, goalies hold on to it because it's a face-off on your end. Ramo moves it. Watch this here. Put it in again. Gets it. Now watch. See that? Nielsen puts it right over. Remember, kids, on a three-on-three, because it's coming to all leagues. Always move that puck and watch this here. Beauty like that, goalie all the time.
All right, because we're showing neat little things. Using the net or the boards to pass to yourself.
This is like your deal. Why don't you talk
on
this?
It's the bank passes. Yeah. You started it, but I'm really into it. Placanus with a beauty here. And the base of the net, as you know now, is even. It used to be in the old days, two bubbles. But with that flat base, and there's, in that case, Ennis using the boards. Goudreau, over and over again, you're going to see Tarasenko, a beauty coming up here.
And when you practice it, kids, make sure you do it, because your coaches, if it doesn't work, will be awful tick. You better know what you're doing.
All right, let me introduce this, too, because we're getting a little tight for time. You did a coach's corner on goalie masks that was a real eye-opener.
Now, think of his stick. Look at that. If his stick had been narrower
or as they go to a point, look at this here now, you'll see one that's unbelievable. And I've always said they should be a little smaller, because if you had a smaller stick, see that there, go ahead, put it in.
There we go, that's Glenn Healy's, he brought his in.
Someday, somebody's going to get in the eye with a narrow stick. You people are always for safety. Do something about it. The goalies wouldn't agree with us.
There you are, and we're going to show. You going to show the other guy?
Marc-Andre Fleury, yeah.
Yeah, well, no, the other guy you said got
oh,
hurt.
No.
You don't have it?
We don't.
All right, now, the other night, or last night, Marc-Andre Fleury, his dad lost his eye. Watch, it gets it in the eye, goes right straight through. Now, I have always said it all even. Watch this here, goes right in his eye. I said it's all even. They should have it that stick never goes through. And look at that there. You telling me, look how close is that. They're talking. See that there? They should have another bar across or something that stick can't go through, because someday somebody's going to lose their eye.
Donald S. Cherry for Movember, and, of course, for Wounded Warriors on the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.